When it comes to loving others, we've seen what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to put our faith into action. This love in action is charity, or service to others. We've read what James and John say about loving and serving others in practical ways. Now we'll focus on our internal attitude. Let's read Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. Be careful not to practice your righteousness in front of others, to be seen by them. If you do, you will have no reward from your Father in heaven. So when you give to the needy, do not announce it with trumpets, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and on the streets, to be honored by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward in full. But when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret. Then your Father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you. If you take this passage literally, it can be confusing. Did people actually sound trumpets before they gave to the needy? No, probably not. Do your hands have eyes that see each other? Nope. Does all of your giving have to be completely anonymous? No. Should most of it? Maybe. But that's not the point. The point Jesus is making here is that our good works should flow out of our love for God and be done for Him. We should not do good works so others can see how giving and charitable we are. This passage is part of the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus has just finished talking about internal issues such as murder, adultery, and loving our enemies. Then he talks about external practices like giving to the poor. His point is that internal and external are both matters of the heart. When it comes to charity, we can have an us-them mindset. We are helping them. We need to change our thinking and our vocabulary. When talking about charity, it would be helpful to remove some words from the conversation, like separate from, different from, better than, less fortunate than, and more blessed than. When it comes right down to it, we are all equal before God. We are all created in His image. We are all fallen. We are all loved. We can all be redeemed by the blood of Jesus that was shed for everyone. And we can all be restored to right relationship with Him. As James teaches us, faith and works go hand in hand. Faith expressed in action is love. And it's how people will know we follow Jesus. Faith without works is dead faith. And works without faith is often just for show. The two go together to be expressed as agape love, as true charity. The attitude of our heart always matters. When we're expressing charity or agape love, there are many attitudes we should get rid of and some positive, charitable attitudes we should put on instead. For example, instead of pride, we need to put on kindness. Instead of guarded giving, we put on generosity. Instead of resentful obligation, put on cheerfulness. Instead of condescension, love. Instead of pity, empathy. Instead of keeping our distance, hospitality. Instead of feeling more blessed, equity. When we show charity this way, people will know we are Christians by our love.